Hello technology lovers, what's up? Couple of weeks ago I made a video review of a great product from WonderFox called HD Video Converter Pro. If you still haven't checked it out, I recommend you to watch that. That can save you a lot of time. By the way, I will link that at the end of this video. Today I'm back with a video review of another very useful product from WonderFox called DVD Ripper Pro. So without any further ado, I'm Prajwal from Technology Gym and let's get started. Welcome back friends, if you have used DVDs, you will know that well-known problems associated with it is portability and taking a backup of its contents. But what if you could convert all your DVDs into a 1:1 flawless digital copy so that you don't need to worry in case of hard times? Well, that's what DVD Ripper Pro promises to do. If you have used HD Video Converter Pro, just like that, it supports insane number of video formats, audio formats and web formats, and also you can convert your copy to a specific handheld device. It uses special DVD decryption technology that not only leads to faster conversions but can also intelligently detect main titles. Interestingly, the official website claims DVD Ripper Pro can compress a 7.5 GB DVD to a digital copy of 1.2 GB without losing any quality. You can download the software from this official website, and also for more information just head over there. I will leave this link in the description below. At the same time, they have some really cool summer offers going on. There's a buy one get one deal as well, so don't forget to check them out. So guys, as I told you, this link will be in the description below. Now let's put the software to test. I have the software ready. The installation process is pretty simple and self-explanatory, so I'm skipping that in order to make this video short. This is how the interface looks. It's pretty simple and intuitive. This is of course the large number of video formats that you can convert to. You can also convert your content specific to a particular device, as you can see here. Every device from Apple, Samsung, Microsoft, Google, Amazon, every major brand and their devices are listed here. Of course, you can backup content that's tailor-made for your 4K TV. At the same time, many web formats and audio formats are also supported, and if this isn't enough, you can also define your own custom format. You can also choose the quality of the digital copy once you select a drive here, and also define the output folder for the backup. Right now I will leave it as it is. Now I will select the drive that's already inserted. It contains large number of video files, which makes good use case for testing. So here it is. As you can see, it automatically selects the main title as it was mentioned in the official website. This DVD contains large number of video files. I think it has more than 70 video files, but right now I'm gonna select only few of them for the purpose of testing, so let me do that fast. So guys, I have selected 17 video files here, including the main title for conversion. You can adjust the quality of the backup using the slider towards right. As you can see here, if you want highest quality conversion, then it'll take pretty longer, but if low quality conversions are acceptable, then it can happen much quicker. So speed and quality are inversely proportional. Right now I'm leaving that default. You can also use the settings menu to achieve greater control over the conversions if you are an advanced user, but right now I'm leaving that default as well. Once you are satisfied with all the settings, just click on the run button and wait for the conversions to happen. It also gives sound feedback every time a conversion ends. By the way, I'm speeding up this process so I can reduce the waiting time. The overall conversion time was 15 minutes. You can see the size of the output file towards right. The actual size of backup was pretty big. Taking that into consideration, I'm actually very happy with the conversion time. If you have large number of files to convert rather than having a single file, which is the case here, it takes some time to convert. But again, it also depends upon the quality and speed settings, and it varies from machine to machine depending upon its hardware. As we are waiting for the conversions to end here, just a small reminder guys, you can download the software free from the official website, and that link is down in the description below. Also do check out the HD Video Converter Factory Pro, for which I have made a video review too. I will link that down at the end of this video, so make sure to watch that. We are almost done with the conversions, guys. Here is the output. Once everything is done, just click on open and you'll be taken directly to the saved folder. And as you can see, here is a digital copy of every file from my DVD which I selected for backup. Just click on the clear button to get rid of all the current activities. Now let's head over to the settings menu to see what it has to offer. You can tweak few settings here like the batch conversion settings, and if you are an advanced user, you can select the number of CPU cores used for conversion or backup and also set CPU priority. You can also define the maximum number of tasks handled. And another useful feature that is built into the tool is that you can add subtitles to a particular video file. I will just show you how you can do that. This is how you can add subtitles to a video. Of course, for that you must have the subtitle file ready. Another cool feature is you can edit a particular file before backup by clicking on the edit button. As you can see here, you can apply various effects and filters, and once you are done, just click on OK and it will be saved. So that's pretty much everything the software can do, guys. Without any doubt, it's a pretty handy tool to have if you still use DVDs. I give it a thumbs up from my side. It's a quick solution to rip your old DVDs into digital copies without losing any quality. Share your opinions in the comment section below, and as usual, give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. For more technology updates, follow our channel page on Twitter. With that, I'm Prajwal from Technology Gym signing off right now, but I hope to see you all again. Until then, goodbye and thank you for watching.